Welcome to this week's video. On this week's video, I'm going to update an old video of mine about what apps you need for an electric car. Now, even if you're a new or old electric car driver, please watch this video. There's some apps and cards in here for charging that even I didn't know about last year, and some new ones that I found out. So stay tuned to this week's video. Now, first of all, let me say the order these apps are in is no indication of how good or bad I think they are. They are completely random locations in the list. Also, all the app links and the description of each app and card is in the description on how to order the cards, how to find the apps, various app stores and stuff like that are all in the description down below. So let's get right into it with number one. Number one is probably the most known app out there by far for any electric car owner, and that is, of course, Plugshare. With over 230,000 locations, Plugshare is one of the largest multi-source Wikipedia-type app-based program. It has a list of pretty much all the chargers. You can find people's home chargers location if they chose to add them. You can add your own home location to it. It's absolutely brilliant. It's a social. Now, you can find nearby chargers to yourself. You can also find info on all the chargers. You can find pictures of where to find these chargers, locations of them. But sometimes the actual ping pong of where the map is doesn't really help you find it. You need a picture to kind of work out in relation of where it is. And you can add pictures if you don't find the pictures there useful enough. You can also check in and add the status of the charge, so you can say charging now, how long you're charging for, to give the next EV driver an indication of how long you're going to be there when they turn up. Route planning is one of the other things that you can do. Route planning is probably my most used feature if I'm doing a very, very long journey. Now, most of the time I just drive and don't do any planning, but if I'm going to a location that doesn't involve a lot of motorway driving and I'm not sure where the charges are, then I'll do a route planner. You can set a starting mileage and an ending mileage of what your car uses per charge, so you can actually get an adequate sort of range guide, and you can add the charger routes on the way to the trip location. You can do it on your computer and then sync it to your phone, and you can also on the computer add wait time, so it gives you an idea of how long the total journey will be with charging time included. You can also send messages from the Plugshare app. Now, this is useful. For example, let's say you've checked in to a destination charger and you've not returned in time for it to be charged, and you thought, oh, there's no rush, there's plenty of destination chargers there. Someone can message you and say, all the charge spaces are full, your car's fully charged, could you please come back so and move it so I can put a charge in. It's a great little feature. It's also useful on checking in for rapids. Someone might message you and say your charge is stopped, but it's a useful feature that I didn't actually know you could do until fairly recently. Thanks to the Plug Seeker for letting me know that you could do that, by the way. Now, the next app is a must if you're ever going to be on the motorway network, and that's ecotricity. Ecotricity have two different ways of using their chargers. One is the app. Pretty straightforward to use. You can scan the barcode on the pump or enter the pump ID. Pump ID is normally quicker, by the way. Then the other way of using their chargers is using one of these, an ecotricity RFID card. With this RFID card, it's free to order off their website, and it enables you to use 22 kilowatt chargers, the untethered 22 kilowatt chargers, so you'll need your type 2 or type 1 cable from your car. Really, these type 2 chargers should be really for Zoe owners or FEV owners, because it's 22 kilowatts. Really, the only car that can utilize a full 22 is the Zoe, and some other vehicles can utilize it as well. It is there free of charge when you tap this. Other ecotricity tariffs are 30p per kilowatt on rapids, unless they're on free vend. There's videos about how to tell if ecotricity are on free vend. I've done other videos and I'll link it on top right. If you're an ecotricity customer, you get it at 15p per kilowatt at the current time of this video. Now, ecotricity, electricity and gas is fairly expensive. I did price researches and it would increase my energy costs by an enormous amount per month. There is a link in the description down below to a company called Octopus Energy. It's 100% green energy tariff. Using my code, you'll get £50 off your first bill. And they also do an EV go tariff, an energy go tariff. If you go to evnick.com, there's a link to that. But if you go directly to there, you won't get 50 quid off. So use the one in my video down below, switch to one of their random standard tariffs, then ring them straight away after you've done the online switch and tell them that you want to go on the EV go tariff. Once they've installed a smart meter, you'll go on the EV go tariff, which is at night 5p per kilowatt hour, and during the day 14p per kilowatt hour, and it's around 14p during the day, depends what geographical location you're in. The next app is CYC, Charge Your Car, which is weirdly part of the Polar Network and obviously now part of BP. Why on earth they need multiple apps for basically the same service, I have no idea. It's also the app you'll need if you go to Scotland. They run the Charge Place Scotland apps as well, so CYC is the apps you need for Scotland. Now, if you live in Scotland, you can get a Charge Place Scotland card by applying for it. So if you live in Scotland, check out that. If you want to learn more about Scotland's charge network, there's a guest vlog from Eleanor, link up there above, and you can get some more information on that. Ireland also have a similar card, and there's a guest vlog from Yambar up there, which you can also see about how to get a card in Ireland to use all the Irish chargers. But back to CYC for a second. CYC will let you access some of the Polar chargers that are not on the Polar Instant app. Why don't you just put them on the Polar Instant app and not be awkward? It's because they want to fool you into getting a Polar Premium subscription to access all the chargers. We'll get in. Look, I might as well incorporate these two apps together. So Polar Instant and Polar Plus. Polar Plus is a membership and you get a little RFID card and you can tap it on chargers, which are CYC chargers, and also other Polar stuff. Polar Instant is instant access to some of the Polar rapid chargers and other rapid and newer chargers they've got. CYC lets you get into some of the older ones which weren't part of Polar, and then Polar bought them out, and it'll let you get into all of them and also Scotland. So that's three lots of apps all incorporated into one, and I'll show all the screens and how they all work there. But basically, they're free apps that you need pretty much if you're driving around all over the place. Oh, just a note, some of the new Polar Rapids now will take RFID card contactless payment. Podpoint is another one, which I love Podpoint. Podpoint, I love you. You install lots of chargers in lots of great locations, and majority of them are free to use. They have Rapids at pretty much all the new Lidl's being built now, and they are free to use Rapids. They also put a load of chargers at Chesterzoo, which I visited not long ago with my niece, and they are all destination chargers, lots of them, and again, totally free. They are brilliant. I love Podpoint. I love the app. The only criticism I have about Podpoint is on the Rapid, where it's completely free and it has a touchscreen that works as soon as you touch it. Why do you need to start a charge on the app? Why can't you just start the charge on the Rapid and stop the charge on the Rapid? I don't get it. I don't understand. I suppose if you could stop the Rapid on the charger, then you might get people stopping your charge while you're charging. But why not just incorporate some kind of, allow other people to tag an RFID card that they trust and let them turn off the charge with their own RFID card, or bank card that doesn't, you know, charge anything, just authorises. I mean, obviously there's an additional cost for the bank charge part, but you could incorporate some kind of RFID card to start and stop the charge. It's my own little pet hate that, you know, for a free Rapid, you have to go on an app and take some time to log in and blah, 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 and start the charge. But apart from that, Podpoint, absolutely brilliant. Great company. Keep up the good work. Now, the next app, card, is Smooth. I think that's how you say it. It's to activate the Shell chargers, the Shell New Motion chargers. Now, first of all, don't download this app. It's crap. You have to go on the app to start the charge, and then the payment system is done on a web page. Why build an app that diverts to a web page? I have no idea. It's rubbish. Don't bother downloading it unless you need the charge immediately today. What you need to do is go to New Motion's website, which is also owned by Shell, and order a New Motion card. Then link this card to on the NewMotion website to your credit or debit card, and this card will allow you to go to a Shell charger and tap the payment. Simple, easy, quick. Why on earth would you download the app? Really? No. Anyway, tap card, link to your credit card, takes a payment. When you also order this card, there's some great things that you can do with it. There's a company called Genie that have been fitting rapids, and great, by the way, they are free triple-headed rapids with AC, CHAdeMO and CCS. And you can link your NewMotion card to the Genie account. Now, Genie starting a charge on their website is also a little bit cumbersome, but once you've linked your RFID card to it, great. Now, to link it to an Genie, you have to go to the Genie, go on the website on your phone at the same time, tell it you're at that charger, and then tap it on that machine while you're with it, and it will remember your card for next time you use it. And I also believe some of their chargers also have RFID for tap contactless card payment, and also for inserting contactless card payment. But it's nice that you can link a third-party RFID card. You can use the NewMotion Shell one or the ecotricity one I showed you before. Doesn't matter, you can use either of them. It's fantastic. The next one is
What's up?
Now, you obviously, if you've not seen that 90s Budweiser advert, then you probably think I'm going nuts. But the next app is called Wattsup, as in Wattsup, as in Watts, as in the electricity measurement. It's under a year old. It's an app that I only know through Eleanor. She introduced me to it. I've not used it much, but it's got tremendous potential. It shows you the latest news for new chargers that have been installed, so that's quite useful. And it's got a route planner. Now, there definitely needs to be some updates to the route planner. It's not as intuitive to use as, for example, Plugshare, where you can see where each charge distance is between each charger. So it's missing that part of the intuitive part of Plugshare. However, on the actual app, it will show you the actual brand of the charger. So unlike Plugshare, where it's just listed as a pop 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 charge and you can't see it all the way down, on the actual Wattsup app, each charger has their icon logo, so you can see all the ecotricity chargers, you can see all the polar chargers straight away directly from the app. And that I do like. That is beautiful. The actual display of it and the way it's done there is perfect. I just think there needs to be some tweaks on the route planner. Now, their route planner does do certain things. It takes into towards gradients and stuff like that, and it's good. It is good, but I do think that the route planner is a little bit cumbersome compared to something like Plugshare, which has just been bought out by the Ionity network as we speak. So there's some breaking news. Ionity is buying Plugshare, so whether they're going to get some surge of investment, or whether that means that people like Wattsup are going to thrive because they might take Plugshare and stop supporting all the other chargers on their map and just use it as an Ionity-based system. And they might take away the social side of it. So at the moment, I think we need to sort of consider people like Wattsup as the new rising apps. And there is a lot of functionality in there which I find really useful and really clever.
The next one is What Three Words. Now, before anyone says it, yes, it's not a charge app. No, it's got nothing to do with electric cars. But I'm going to tell you why it's in the list and why I think you should download it. And also, if you're working for any of the companies that I've just mentioned before who make charge maps for charging things like Plugshare and stuff like that, why I think that you should incorporate What3Words into your system.
What3Words is a sat-nav app. It's fantastic. You basically can pick any geo square anywhere in the world, and it will give you three randomly unique words that will get you to that destination. Now, the reason I think it's good for electric car drivers is on maps when you're trying to find chargers, they'll never wear the postcode or location on the service actually says it is, apart from Plugshare, which tends to be a bit more accurate, but they don't tend to be exactly where they want. With What3Words, you give the person three words and that will take them exactly to the geo point on that map where that charger is. This would even work if there was a random off-road charger in the middle of nowhere. The
best part about it is those three words, even if they sound the same, if you say those three words the same to someone over the phone and they misheard you and type it in, those similar sounding words are on the opposite side of the globe, so there's no confusion that basically you've got the wrong one. You'll go, ah, they must have said that word wrong, and maybe they meant this instead of that. And that's how you can get around it. It's a fantastic piece of software, because if you've got a charger, for example, the Trafford Centre, they've got some chargers near the Go Ape part, Go Outside part, which are fairly hard to find if you're using the Renault Zoe app or some other apps which just basically use the postcode location of the Trafford Centre, and it just gets you into any of the random Trafford Centre car parks. With What Free Words, you can use the free words and go directly to that charger immediately. Easily found, easily there. It's fantastic. I fully recommend you download it and have a look at it. Companies like Mercedes are going to start incorporating into their sat nav, so you could say three words to your Mercedes sat nav, it'll know that geolocation of that app and it will send you to that location using just three words. It is amazing, amazing. The next obvious one is the dedicated app for your car, whether it be the Renault ZE services app, the Tesla app, the BMW connected app, whichever app it is, get the app for your car. It has a minefield of features for certain cars, whether that be a preheat in the morning on cold days, a pre-cool in the summer on hot days, setting a charge schedule delay, which I'm going to get into why that's more important in a second, and also if you've gone to the tariff listed in the description for Octopus, why charge delaying would be better at 12:30 to 4:30 when their cheap tariff is, and other nighttime rates if you're on Economy 7. But there's some fantastic features that you can do on your dedicated charge app, and I fully advise that you download the app made for your car. Now, there's two apps here called Grid Carbon and GridWatch. Both of them are fantastic little apps, and what they do is allow you to find out the grid intensity of carbon on the grid, basically what's being produced, coal, wind, solar, and basically work out what that intensity is, and they give an indication of colour of how green or dirty it is. So obviously lots of coal generation means that you're basically the high CO2 and it'll be red, and low, lots of wind, lots of solar means it's really low sort of CO2 limit on the grid, and that means that it's better to plug your electric car in when the grid is clean, less CO2. Now, traditionally, this also happens at night during the peak and trough. So as you can see, when you turn the app sideways on Grid Carbon, you can see the peaks and troughs. And at night is the greenest time to plug your grid in. It's the lowest coal, most redundant wind not being used. And that's the best time to charge your electric car on a charge delay. Even if you don't have an Eco 7 tariff or the Optimus tariff, which is listed down in the description, I fully advise that you set your charge schedule to happen at night. It's greener for the grid and it helps balance the grid, and also in turn it will bring down electricity prices, which there'll be a future video about can the grid cope in a few weeks. As always, thanks very much for watching this week's video. Don't forget to click subscribe, consider becoming a patron, and check out my other videos. Thanks very much, and I'll see you again next week. Goodbye.